क्लास 10 चैप्टर नंबर 5 स्नैक एंड द मिरर बाय वैकोम मोहम्मद बसीर एंड दिस ट्रांसलेटेड इन इंग्लिश फ्रॉम द मलयालम बाय वी अब्दुल्ला. सो हियर मिरर एंड यू कैन सी द स्नैक्स. द स्टोरी इज ऑल अबाउट अ डॉक्टर. लेट्स सी introduction of the lesson. That the story is a narrative within the narrative. Writer tells us the story which was told to him by a homeopathic doctor one who told the story to the writer. So here the narrator, it means who is the writer. Writer himself say tell this story. Here nothing like the second persons to whom the story is means given, or to whom the story here tell by the other, but the person who tell this story by himself. And this story is all about a homeopathic doctor. As we see from the title, the snack and the mirror are the two most important thing in this story also. And not only the homeopathic doctor in the story is the vital part, but the other vital part is mirror and the snack, as we have the title, right? So this both the things are very important even in this story. The most important things in the story is this three: doctor, mirror and the snack. This homeopathic doctor encountered a snake. The snake fell onto doctor. When the snake saw its reflection in the mirror, it was more interested in that, and the doctor's life was saved. This is the story all about that one day how somehow accidentally a doctor encounter with the snake, but thank God for the, to that mirror. That mirror was there, and when this snake show another snake like things in the mirror as his reflection, he thought another snake is there, and he liked that other snakes, interested in snakes, so somehow he forget to bat that doctor, and doctor saved his life from the snake. Let's start the lesson. Here we have lesson in black word student, then I will explain you hard words which will in blue color, and then the explanation of this para which will in red color. So black, blue and red, it's all about black means the para directly from the text, blue means the hard words, and red means the explanation. Okay, let's see. Here you can see in the picture how the snake called to the doctor, right? Has a snake ever coiled itself round any part of your body? Coiled round means like this. In the picture you can see a full-blooded cobra. All of us fell silent. The question came from the homeopath doctor. The topic came up when we were discussing snacks. We listened attentively as the doctor continued with his tale. It was a hot summer night, about 10 o'clock. I had my meal at the restaurant and turned to my room. I heard a noise from above as I opened the door. Now here in red color we have explanation of that para. See, the homeopathic doctor is narrating the story, means is telling the story itself, right? And he asked the writer and the group if anyone had ever been grabbed by a cobra snake, and the audience became silent due to the fear of the cobra snake. And then the doctor narrated his stories that it was a hot summer night, almost 10 o'clock. He was returning home after having his dinner at the restaurant, and as the doctor was opening the door of his room, he heard a noise from above, but he did not react about he was used to such a noise. means here the doctor who tells the story to the writer and the people, they were engaged somewhere, right? And he tells all the incidents, how he encountered with the snake. It from the very first that he said, when I opened the door, I heard some noise above, but it was a casual noise, as generally he heard such a noise from, I think, a mouse and all. That's why he said. See here, you can see in the picture. The sound was a familiar one. One could see that the rats and I shared the room. He was used to listen to this kind of noise, and it was the noise of rats, I think, mouse noise. And there were many rats in his room, so he was used to the noise. So when he entered in the room, he heard the noise, so he thought that the noise come from the kitchen, maybe from the rats. Took out my box of matches and lit the kerosene lamp. See, here is the kerosene lamp in red color, you can see. On the table, the house was not electrified. It was a small rented room. Electricity was not there. That's why he lit up the kerosene lamp. There was no light in the doctor's room, so he lighted the kerosene lamp with a matchbox, and he had taken a small room on rent. I had just set up medical practice and my earnings were much. I had about 60 rupees in my suitcase, along with some shirts and dhotis. I also possessed one solitary black coat with which was then wearing. See, dhoti means, here you can see in the picture, this called dhoti. You may have seen the dhotis, right? Much, small in quantity means possessed. Okay, much means small in quantity, and possessed means had, and solitary means single. So as he had just started his medical practice, he was earning very less. That is why he was living in such a shabby, dirty condition. And he told the writer that he had just 60 rupees in his bag. Further, he added that he had some shirts and dhotis to wear. He also had a black colored coat which he was wearing at the time of the incident. When the incident happened of that snake, that time he wearing that black colored coat. As he said that he had only 60 rupees and dhotis and kurtas and all. I took off my black coat, white shirt and not so white vest, and hung them up. He removed his coat, his shirt and his vest, and he says that the vest was not so white, which means that is it was very dirty, which he wore, it was very dirty. Here, see, glabe is there in this para, but glabe means here you can see. It's a part of a house, like this kind of triangle. It's called GABLE, glab. Okay. Open the two windows in the room. It was an outer room with one wall fencing open the yard. It had a tiled roof with long supporting glabs. See, long supporting glabs that rested on the beam over the wall. There was no ceiling. There was a regular traffic of rats to and fro the beam. So yard is an open area like a garden or veranda. And glab means upper part of a wall below a sloping roof. Jo sloping roof hoti hai uske upper part. Okay. So then he opened the windows. The room which he had taken on rent was on the outside of the house, and one wall of the room faced the garden. Means one wall it's faced the garden, means in front of the garden, and the roof had tiles on it, and the gable was supported by the beam. Jo beam hote hai na, those pillars, that those pillars on the roof like that. Inside the roof, there was no roof. Inside the room, roof nahi thi means chhat nahi thi. The beam on which the glaive was supported was full of rats, which went in and out of the room through it. And only glaive is there which support the beams, and from glaive, rats come and go from in the house. I made my bed and pulled it close to the wall. I lay down, but I could not sleep. I got up and went out the veranda for a little air, but the wind god seems to have taken time off. Taken time off means to take a day off or take a holiday. Means wind had gone, I think, when he go out. He set his bed near the wall and he laid down to sleep, but could not sleep. And it seems that the wind god had taken time off means that as the wind was not blowing, the wind god had taken a day off. And he was on a holiday, and so wind was not blowing at all. He thought that wind is now no more in the garden because it is maybe in the holiday, on the holiday. He had gone out to get some fresh air because he did not have any fan or cooler in his room, and he was feeling very hot inside the room. I went back into the room and sat down on the chair. I opened the box beneath the table and took out a book. The Materia Medica. I opened it at the table on which stood the lamp and a large mirror. A small comb lay beside the mirror. As I show the pictures, like that kind of scene is there. He came back to his room and sat on the chair, and he opened the box under the table and took out a book named Materia Medica. It's medical book or something like that. He kept it on the same table on which a lamp, a mirror and a small comb was lying. He opened it and sat down. One feels tempted to look into a mirror when it is near one. I took a look. In those days, I was a great admirer of beauty, and I believed in making myself look handsome. It means as he was sitting in front of the mirror, he looked at his image in the mirror, and he says that he was a great admirer of beauty. It means people admire his beauty when he was young. As he was young man, he liked to appreciate beautiful things and wanted to improve his looks to look more handsome. I was unmarried and I was a doctor. I felt I had to take my presence felt. As he was unmarried and he was a doctor too, he was a eligible bachelor. So he wanted to make people know that he was also available. Means he wants a girl. I picked up the comb and ran it through my hair and adjusted the parting so that it looked straight and neat. So he combed his hair trying to set them properly. As he was started to try to read the books, but in front of him there was mirror, so constantly he looked his face at the mirror and he combed his hair. As generally this happened with the girls, right, that whenever we show the mirror as a girl, we only try to do makeup and all. So like a girl, this narrator tried to do. Again I heard that sound from above. Again he heard the sound. When he was combing his hair, he again heard the same sound from the above, but he ignored that. I think maybe there is rat or mouse over there. I took a close look at my face in the mirror. I made an important decision. I would shave daily and grow a thin mustache to look more handsome. See, he looked carefully in the mirror and decided that he would shave daily and grow a thin mustache. Means मूछें जो होती है वो उसे उगानी चाहिए और उसे शेविंग करनी चाहिए. बिकॉज ही थॉट दैट ही वुड लुक बेटर एंड मोर हैंडसम विथ इट. सो ही वॉज थिंकिंग अबाउट हिज लुकिंग एंड हाउ ही कैन लुक सो हैंडसम एंड ऑल. आई वॉज आफ्टर ऑल अ बैचलर एंड अ डॉक्टर. ही सेड अ बैचलर मीन्स अ मैन हु इज नॉट एंड हैज नेवर बीन मैरिड. Not being married or never been married, जो अकेले होते हैं उसे bachelor बोलते हैं, कुंवार है. So the doctor repeats that he was not married and he was a doctor also. So he wanted to say that he was supposed to look very handsome, as he was supposed to be good looking so that he could get a better match for himself or better girl for himself. I looked into the mirror and smiled. It was an attractive smile. I made another earth-shaking decision. I would always keep that attractive smile on my face to look more handsome. Earth-shaking decision means, student, here something very important. He appreciated himself and said that he had an attractive smile. Another thing that he decided was that he was always keep smiling because he looked better when he smiled. And the doctor was being ironic when he said that to keep smiling was an earth-shaking decision. Means it's important decision for him. If he keeps smiling, then he looks so better and handsome. I was, after all, a bachelor and a doctor too. On top of it, he again said that I, after all, मैं एक डॉक्टर हूँ और ऊपर से कुंवारा हूँ, तो मुझे तो स्माइल करनी चाहिए, दाढ़ी निकाल के मूछें रखनी चाहिए और हैंडसम दिखना चाहिए. सो लाइक दैट काइंड ऑफ थिंग ही कॉन्स्टेंटली सेड. अगेन कैम दैट नॉइज फ्रॉम अबव. नाउ अगेन दैट नॉइज कैम फ्रॉम अबव. ऑन टॉप ऑफ इट मीन्स टू एड ऑन टू समथिंग. Now again he is tracing that he was a bachelor and to add to it was also doctor. So he thought that he had a lot of value and that is why he wanted to look handsome. I got up, placed up and down the room. As he again heard the noise from the above, so he got up, placed up and down the room. Then another lovely thought struck me. I would marry. Another thought came to his mind that he thought that I would marry. I would get married to a woman doctor who had plenty of money and a good medical practice. She had to be fat for a valid reason. If I made some silly mistake and needed to run away, she could not be able to run after me and catch me. So here very humorically he thought about his wife, right? Past means walked and valid means logical or justifiable. If it's logical, if it is valid like that, and past means walked. So he got up from his chair and started walking up and down in the room. And then what he decided one more thing, that to marry a woman doctor and one who have lots of money and medical practice. And further also, doctor thought that he would marry a fat girl. Why? Because for that he had a logical reason. That he reasoned that if sometime he makes some mistake and his wife chases him, or his wife run toward him in anger to hit him, she will not be able to run fast and catch him if she would be fat. So ये डॉक्टर सेड दैट आई वांट अ वेरी फैट एंड रिच डॉक्टर लेडी. फैट बिकॉज इफ समटाइम आई डू मिस्टेक एंड शी वॉन्ट टू बीट मी बट शी कुड नॉट कैच एज शी वुड बी फैट. सो हियर डॉक्टर इज कॉन्स्टेंटली थिंकिंग अबाउट हीज ऑन लुकिंग हिज वाइफ एंड ही वॉज ड्रीमिंग एंड इमेजिनिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ मिरर. सी हियर वी हैव पिक्चर दैट वाई डॉक्टर थॉट दैट ही वॉन्ट फैट वाइफ, कि जब भी पीछे दौड़ेगी मारने के लिए तो वो मुझे पकड़ नहीं पाएगी. दैट्स वाई थॉट आई वॉन्ट फैट वाइफ. विद सच थॉट्स इन माई माइंड आई रिज्यूम्ड माई सीट इन द चेयर इन फ्रंट ऑफ द टेबल. There was no more sound from above. Suddenly, there came a dull thud, as if a rubber tube had fallen to the ground. Surely nothing to worry about. Let's see what is there. Thinking all these things, the doctor again sat down on the chair, and now the sound had stopped. But all of a sudden, what happened? समथिंग फेल डाउन मेकिंग द साउंड ऑफ अ थर्ड. थर्ड जैसी आवाज़ आई. थर्ड मीन्स जब कुछ अचानक गिरता है तो क्या आवाज़ आती है, दैट्स कॉल्ड थर्ड. एंड इट फेल्ट लाइक सम रबर ट्यूब हैड फॉलन एंड द डॉक्टर डिड नॉट बॉदर अबाउट इट. ही थॉट दैट रबर ट्यूब गिरी होगी एंड ही डिडंट बॉदर अबाउट इट, मीन्स उसे कोई चिंता नहीं थी उसकी कि जो भी गिरा हो कुछ रबर ट्यूब गिरी होगी. Even so, I thought I would turn around and take a look. But then he thought of turning around to see what had fallen. So he turned. As he didn't care about it, he thought the tube giri hogi, but he turned and to look over it. No sooner had I turned than a fat snake wriggled over the back of the chair and landed on my shoulder. See, like this in the picture. The snakes landing on me and my turnings were simultaneous. So wriggle means crawled and simultaneous means crawled. So wriggle means crawl, but crawling means kya? If you have seen that जो स्नैक्स होते हैं दे डोंट हैव लैग्स, कैटरपिलर्स होते हैं उसको भी लैग्स नहीं होते हैं, तो वो कैसे क्रॉल करते हैं ज़मीन पे या कोई भी छत पे, तो वो लैग्स नहीं होने के कारण क्रॉल करते हैं, तो दैट्स कॉल्ड रिगल्ड. ओके, साइमल्टेनियस मीन्स हैपन्ड एट द सेम टाइम. साइमल्टेनियस मीन्स सेम टाइम, जब कुछ भी चीज़ होती है. So as soon as the doctor turned, he showed that a big fat snake had crawled over the chair and sat on his shoulders pe baith gaya. The timing of the doctor's turning around and the snake's landing on his shoulder was same. Jo timing tha doctor ka ghumne ka aur snake ka landing karne ka, wo same tha. I didn't jump, I didn't tremble, I didn't cry out. There was no time to do any such a things. Actually, he did not panic, jump or tremble. He did not even shiver, he did not even scream. It happened so fast, so instantly that he did not have any time to react on that. That poet ne panic ne. सॉरी राइटर पैनिक नहीं हुआ, उसने जंप नहीं किया, उसने ट्रेम्बल मीन्स पूरा वाइब्रेशन नहीं हुआ, शिवरिंग मीन्स ऑल्सो शिवर मीन्स वाइब्रेट नहीं किया, चिल्लाया नहीं, स्क्रीम मीन्स. तो वाई उसने चिल्लाया नहीं, डरा नहीं, बिकॉज सडनली वो थिंग्स हुआ कि जैसे ही उसने टर्न किया अचानक से शोल्डर पे स्नेक आ गया. सो देर वॉज नो टाइम टू रिएक्ट ऑन दैट सिचुएशन फॉर द राइटर. The snake slithered along my shoulders and coiled around my left arm above the elbow. Slithered means twisting and crawling motion of the snake. See here we have this called coiling or slithered like things, okay? कॉइलिंग, जैसे कि स्नेक कॉइल करता है ना, ऐसे बैठता है गोल गोल राउंड में लाइक दैट ट्विस्ट करके. द स्नेक मूव्ड इन सच अ वे दैट इट रैप्ड इटसेल्फ ऑन द डॉक्टर्स लेफ्ट आर्म लाइक अ कॉइल. सो लेफ्ट आर्म पे कॉइलिंग हो गया पूरा स्नेक. द हुड वॉज स्प्रेड आउट एंड इट्स हेड वॉज हार्डली 3 or 4 inches फ्रॉम माई फेस. और जब हाथ पे स्नेक बैठ गया था कॉइल करके, तो वो हुड खोल के बैठ गया था. सी हुड मीन्स हियर यू कैन सी द फेस. जनरली वी कैन सी दिस हुड व्हेन दी स्नेक्स रन और सिट, बट व्हेन इट्स सीट विथ कॉइलिंग देन यू कैन सी इन एस शेप व्हेन इट कॉइल्ड और इट एंगर्स. मीन्स वो पूरा हुड खोल के बैठता है, तो लाइक दैट बैठ गया हेड ऑफ द स्नेक. हुड मीन्स इट वॉज इन सच अ पोजिशन जस्ट 3-4 inches अवे फ्रॉम हिज फेस दैट इफ ही वुड हैव मूव्ड स्लाइटली द स्नेक कुड हैव बीटन हिम. दैट ही थॉट ही सेड दैट द स्नेक वॉज 3 or 4 inches फार अवे फ्रॉम हिज फेस. इफ वो थोड़ा सा भी हिलता तो उसे बाइट कर लेता, उसे काट लेता. इट वुड नॉट बी करेक्ट टू से मैनली that I sat there holding my breath. I was turned to stone, but my mind was very active. Now the doctor say that he was not only holding his breath, but had turned into a stone, just like a statue. Although physically he was still like a statue, but his mind was very actively. And he was thinking what he should do next. Actually, he said that at that time when snake crawled on my left arms, at that time he could not move. But of course, his mind was very active and it was moving. He was constantly thinking that what could I do next. जो वो नहीं सोचता तो snake उसे beat ही कर लेता. That was definitely final. The door opened into darkness. In the light of the lamp, I sat there like a stone image in the flesh. So there was darkness all around him, outside the room, inside the room. It was all very dark, and there was only single light, the light of the lamp. And in that light, he was sitting like a statue. I felt then the great presence of the creator of this world and this universe. God was there. As he was in trouble, he started feeling the presence of God, and he was not able to do anything, so he started thinking of God. Suppose I said something and he did not like it. I tried in my imagination to write in bright letters outside my little heart the words, "Oh God." So he decided not to speak less, lest he should anger the snake. If he speak, then of course snake become angry. So in his heart, the doctor was praying to God to save his life. There was some pain in my left arm. It was as if a thick leaden rod, no, a rod made of molten fire, was slowly but powerfully crushing my arm. The arm was beginning to be drained of all strength. What could I do? Now, as this snake has called itself, it had wrapped itself around his arm, so it was experiencing a lot of pain, and he was feeling as if a thick molten rod made of lead was crushing his arm and breaking it. And again, here narrator felt helpless. He could not do anything to save himself, because saap uske samne uske haathon mein to kya kar sakta hai wo bhi. At this slightest movement, the snake would strike me. Death locked 4 inches away. Strike means attack and locked means hide. Hid. So he knew that if he moved a bit, the snake would attack him, and death was very near. It was sitting at a distance of 4 inches only. Suppose it struck. What was the medicine I had to take? There were no medicine in the room. I was but a poor, foolish, and stupid doctor. I forgot my danger and smiled feebly at myself. Feebly means very weakly. Now he thought that if the snake bit him, okay, then what would he do? Which medicine he would take? And then he recalled that there was no medicine in his room. At that time when the snake was there on his head, he thought that if snake bite him, don't worry, I will take medicine. But very next he recalled, means he remembered, that there is no medicine in this house. So he felt that he was a poor, foolish and stupid doctor, and he was feeling very weak, and as he did not have any way to come out of this situation, he smiled at his foolishness only, that I, as a doctor, I don't have medicine and I don't know how to escape from this situation. So he smiled at his own foolishness. It seemed as if God appreciated that the snake turned its head. It looked into the mirror and saw its reflection. So the doctor felt that the God appreciated the doctor's realization of this mistake, and something favorable happened and the doctor's life was saved. Why? Because the snake moved its head to the other side and showed the mirror. It looked at the mirror and it showed its own reflection in it. So here we can see that doctor saved his life, because तब क्या हुआ कि जो स्नैक था वो मिरर के सामने देखने लगा, उसके रिफ्लेक्शन के सामने. सो फाइनली उसके हाथों से जो उसके सामने देख रहा था, वो फाइनली जाके अभी मिरर में देख रहा है. यू कैन सी हियर, सी कैसे स्नैक अपने आप को मिरर में देख रहा है. आई डू नॉट क्लेम दैट इट वॉज द फर्स्ट स्नैक दैट हैड एवर लुक्ड इन टू अ मिरर, बट इट वॉज सर्टेन दैट the snake was looking into the mirror. Means here, it is not possibly that any snake had never looked at itself in the mirror before, but yes, this snake was looking at itself in the mirror, and the doctor was surprised because this snake was looking at itself in the mirror very carefully. So here again doctor said that I don't think that before any snake have seen their face on the mirror or not, but this is the snake which I know that it's looking itself in the mirror. Was it admiring its own beauty? He was thinking that maybe it was admiring its beauty. Was it trying to make an important decision about growing a mustache or using eyeshadows and mascara or wearing a vermilion spot on its forehead? It means, see, vermilion spot means red bindi. जो हम red bindi लगाते हैं ना as an Indian girl or woman, वो vermilion होता है. So the doctor imagined that the snake must be imagining a different style, like he was thinking few minutes back when he was looking at his face in the mirror, and he thought that maybe the snake was thinking of the growing mustache or maybe of wearing eyeshadows and mascara to look more pretty, or maybe it was thinking of wearing a red colored bindi on it. It's forehead. So here जो poet writer है जो sorry वो सोचने लगा कि शायद जो सांप है अपने आप को देखता होगा कि मैंने बिंदी लगाई या मस्करा लगाओ, लिपस्टिक करूँ, क्या करूँ, तो वो सोच का अपने आप को देखता होगा. तो लाइक वेरी ह्यूमरिकल और लाफिंग वे ही थॉट अबाउट दिस. So student, I did not know anything for certain what sex was this snake, means which gender snake it is, whether girl or boy. Was it male or female? I will never know. For the snake unwound itself from my arm and slowly slithered into my lap. From there, it crept onto the table and moved toward the mirror. Perhaps it wanted to enjoy its reflection at closer quarter. Closer quarter means to get a closer look. So here you can see that the doctor did not know whether it was a male or female snake, and he says that he will never come to know this, because just then it crawled from his arm and moved down into his lap. From there, it jumped and started crawling over the table. It crawled very close to the mirror and started looking at itself. The doctor thought that maybe snake wanted to look at itself and have a closer look at its appearance. See, I was no more image cut in granite. I was suddenly a man of flesh and blood. He said that granite means from of a marble, as you know, the form of marble, green color, black color granite is there in platform in kitchen, right? So the doctor was no longer a mass statue made of stones, but as soon as the snake crawled and got down from his him, he came back to life. Means now he thought that, now he felt so relief that finally it has gone from the hand. Still holding my breath, I got up from the chair. I quietly went out through the door into the veranda. From there, I leaped into the yard and ran for all I was worth. All I was worth means all the strength that I had. So as the snake had crawled out of the doctor's lap, he stood up. Till now, he had stopped his breath because he was scared of the snake now. And he quietly moved out of the door, jumped from the garden and ran away. Phew! Each of us heaved a sigh of relief. Somebody asked, "Doctor, is your wife very fat?" All the people who were listening. So here the story ends of doctor's incident, how he encounter with the snake, right? But now the people who are listening, who were listening this story from the doctor, means writer himself plus his other friend. So they asked him that, "Doctor, all the people who were listening to the doctor's story got relief and took a deep breath after they came to know that he was saved." And someone from that group asked him whether his wife was fat or not. "No," the doctor said, "God willed otherwise. My life companion is a thin, reedy person with the gift of a sphincter." Reedy person means a thing or person resembling a tall, right? Tall like this. Here you can see in the picture. Thin means a leaved and plant of the grass family. So here replied that his wife was thin and tall, just like a reed plant, because God didn't want his wife to be fat, and so she was thin and could run very fast. Someone else asked, "Doctor, when you ran, did the snake follow you?" Other person asked that from the group that asked him that whether the snake chased him or not as he ran out the home. At that time, snake followed him or not? Doctor replied, "I ran and ran till I reached a friend's house. Immediately, I smeared oil all over myself, took a bath. I changed into fresh clothes." Smeared means covered with. So he replied that he ran and ran till he reached a friend's house. There he took an oil massage, took bath and wore fresh clothes. He did not know if the snake had chased him or not, because he did not look behind him. क्योंकि आप एक बार सांप से भाग जाते हो तो पीछे कौन देखता है. सो लाइक दैट बिकॉज ही डिड नॉट लुक बिहाइंड सो ही सेड आई डोंट नो अबाउट वेदर ही चेज मी और नॉट ही ट्राई टू. सो द नेक्स्ट मॉर्निंग एट अबाउट 8:30 आई टुक माई फ्रेंड एंड वन और टू अदर टू माई रूम टू मूव माई थिंग्स फ्रॉम देयर बट वी फाउंड वी हैड लिटिल टू कैरी. लिटिल टू कैरी मीन्स हिज बिलोंगिंग वाज स्टॉलन एंड देयर वॉज नथिंग मच लेफ्ट टू कैरी अवे. मीन्स दरवाज़ा ओपन करके ही वो भाग गया था ना इसलिए. सो द नेक्स्ट डे अराउंड 8:30 इन द मॉर्निंग द डॉक्टर अलॉन्ग विद टू ऑफ हिज फ्रेंड्स went to the room to bring his belonging means bring his all the things like a suitcase and coat and dhoti and all but there was not much stuff to take. Some thief had removed most of my things. Here you can see the thief. Jab writer doctor wahan se bhag gaya tha tab thief aake sab kuch tha wo le gaye chor. चोरी कर गए. सम थीफ हैड रिमूव्ड मोस्ट ऑफ माई थिंग्स. द रूम हैड बीन क्लीन्ड आउट बट नॉट रियली. द थीफ हैड लेफ्ट बिहाइंड वन थिंग एज अ फाइनल इंसल्ट. व्हाट वॉज दैट आई आस्क्ड. आई मीन्स राइटर आस्क्ड. द डॉक्टर सी माई वेस्ट एंड द डर्टी वन. द फेलो हैड सच अ सेंस ऑफ क्लीनलीनेस. द रास्कल could have taken it and used it after washing it with soap and water. A rascal means a mischievous or cheeky person, especially a child or a man, a naughty person. So someone has stolen most of the things from his room but left behind one thing, and that is he thought that the thing which he left behind was to insult him, because the writer asked the doctor what was the thing which the thief left behind, and he replied that he left the vest which was dirty and was hanging on the wall. He added that the thief was so much into cleanliness that he left the dirty vest there only. He says that the naughty thief could have taken it along with him, washed it with soap, and could have used it. Did you see the snake the next day, doctor? Someone asked the doctor if he saw the snake the next day. The doctor laughed. I have never seen it since. It was a snake which was taken with its own beauty. Taken with means attracted by. So he laughed and replied that after that night he never saw that snake. Maybe the snake was attracted toward its own beauty. That is why it looked so carefully in the mirror. So here we come to the end of this chapter, that how at last doctor give answer of all those people who listen this story eagerly, that at last he didn't find out the snake in the house, but he lost all the things, all the stuffs which were in the house by the thieves. And how he saved his life from the cobra snake. So this is the humorical and very enlightenment story. Here we finally come to the end of the story, student. For today, this much only. We'll discuss the next poem in next session. Till then, stay home, stay safe, and learn well. Thank you.